Hello, my name is Kurt Worley. I am the quantitative analyst at fxbootcamp.com. Today is Wednesday, July 22nd, 2009. This is your New York session video technical briefing. It's a video review of some of the things we covered in the live class today at fxbootcamp.com during the New York session. Let me first clarify that the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. This is not an alert service. The currency coaches do not make trade recommendations. However, we do conduct real-time technical and fundamental analysis to help you put together your trade plans throughout the day. We assume that our newer Bootcamp members are trading on a demo account, so that regardless of whether or not any particular trade plan is successful, they will certainly have an opportunity to learn and eventually trade in their own live accounts for years to come, both profitably and independently. What you now see is a 15-minute chart for the Euro-USD currency pair as it looked at 8 a.m. New York time on GFT's DealBook 360 trading platform using the FX Bootcamp custom layout. Now, I thought this chart sums up what traders in today's prior sessions have dealt with in the currency markets today. The Euro-USD is the most liquid pair by far in the foreign exchange market, and it's been basically flat to this point in the day. Now, I pointed this out during today's London lunch session at FX Bootcamp, as did Chief Currency Coach Wayne McDonald during the New York session. Now, the fact that it's range, actually, let me draw the range. The fact that we're range-bound here, ping-ponging between sources of resistance and support, the fact that we're range-bound isn't necessarily a bad thing. A trader can certainly make money from range trading. What I find discouraging about this is that the width of this range is merely 40 pips or so. 40 pips on a currency pair with an average daily range to more than three times that amount. Now, this kind of range is basically noise, even for most day traders. By the way, the gray-colored Bollinger Bands have been mostly flat and parallel to each other, and the moving averages are either flat or crisscrossing one another. Now, this kind of price action on a day with no major U.S. news reports in the middle of summer, which, by the way, is a time of year notorious for low volatility in multiple financial markets, all of that suggests either a do-nothing day or you put on your scalper's hat and use the short-term time frame charts to take trades that might last, say, only 15 to 30 minutes, maybe longer. Now, one thing I'll often do when in doubt about direction for the day in a range-bound scenario such as one you're seeing on the Euro-USD is simply pick a direction based on the movement of financial markets over most recent trading days. Now, I know that the NASDAQ 100 Composite Index, for example, has been rising for the past 10 trading days in a row, and the other major U.S. stock indexes have been mostly rising during that same span of time. Now, although I see both fundamental and even technical reasons to believe that some kind of correction in stocks is well overdue, one common trader's axiom comes to mind. Do not fight the tape. Again, do not fight the tape. Until it changes, I'm going to assume that the bias in U.S. stocks is still more up than down. When stocks rise, we tend to see the Japanese yen get weaker. Yen weakness means up on the yen pair. And with that in mind, one way to trade today's New York session was to seek only opportunities to scalp up on one or more of the yen pairs with the mindset that maybe one of those scalp trades could be converted into what we call a spot trade that you could hold for an hour or maybe more. Now, honestly, I'm not one of the world's biggest scalp traders, but one setup I did find palatable during today's New York session came together on the pound yen. Let's take a look at that. Here's a 15-minute chart for the British pound and the Japanese yen. Standard 15-minute chart on the left, and on the right is an hourly chart with daily pivot points. Now, minutes after the open of London session, this pair bounced at a level, you can see on the hourly chart here on the right, this pair bounced at a level about a dozen pips above today's M1 pivot point, which is denoted by the horizontal green line just above 152. Now, minutes after today's New York Open, going down to the left on the 15-minute chart, minutes after today's New York Open and the release of Q2 earnings by Morgan Stanley and Wells Fargo, two major U.S. banks, we got a higher low right there. There's a higher low a few minutes after the New York Open. And at the open of U.S. equity markets at 9:30 a.m. New York time, we get basically a matching low. A matching low right there, followed by in this case with this green candle. That's the meatiest green candle this pair has produced so far today on this 15-minute chart. So a low near today's M1, London traders pushed the pair up, and New York traders have failed to match the London Open lows on a month when the predominant theme in the markets has been up, as I just mentioned a minute ago. Seems reasonable to consider at least a long scalp trade. All I need to do now is identify a source of support at which I can buy. Now that's trading 101, right? Buy on a dip at support. Now for identification of intraday support, I find the 3-minute chart extremely helpful. What you see now is a 3-minute chart showing the price action during yesterday's New York session, and you can see down in here. You can see down here that the pound yen found solid support for more than an hour at the 153.20 level. Again, 153.20. And on the lower right, you can just make out down here, you can just make out part of a bounce in the early part of the Asian session at that same level. Now shifting forward in time to today's price action thus far, I see even more evidence that 153.20 has served as a temporary source of both support and resistance. Another swing low there during the Asian session. See all the congestion, all the hesitation around there before London Open. And more recently after the New York Open, pause right there, temporary support, and particularly resistance right here and here. In fact, I'm particularly encouraged to see that even New York traders have recognized the 153.20 level. Now, that gives me more confidence that the pound yen will find support at that level on a drop in price after the rise in this pair since the U.S. equity market open, which you can see right here. Broke above 153.20. Shifting now to the 1-minute chart. Just before 10 a.m. New York time, we did get one retest after the break above 153.20. We did get one retest right here. Now, if you're conservative, what you didn't like about that setup was the fact that stochastics on this 1-minute chart were already way, way overbought. See stochastics down here in the overbought zone. Now, a better setup came 20 minutes later when you had stochastics deep in the oversold zone, as you see down here on the right. Stochastics way oversold there as price is retesting yet again the 153.20 level right there. And also, by the way, a minor uptrend support line was there as well for good measure. So stochastics cross in the oversold area as a common signal for taking a long scalp trade. If you took it, your entry is somewhere between 153.25 and 153.30. Throw in that green candle right there. Now, as for an exit strategy, you might be willing to allow for price to overshoot support by a dozen pips or so. And I see we have a psychological level at 153.00, so you can position your stop loss, say 50 to 70 pips below your entry for catastrophic loss protection, and exit this trade for a loss of, say, no more than 30 pips if price breaches 153, or again, dips below 153. Or you might decide that because it's a mostly directionless day, yesterday's actual low on this pair at 153.10, you may decide that is your line in the sand because you have a low tolerance for losing pips when the market is like this. Again, we're basically range bound. Now, if this setup doesn't work, stochastics then crosses and price breaches 153.10, maybe then you decide to call it a day, close that trade for a small loss, and look for better trade setups tomorrow. Back now on a 3-minute chart. Moving forward in time, 3-minute increments. After price breaks above the previous resistance level at 153.75, denoted by this horizontal light gray line, you can move your stop a few pips below that to lock in some profits. So maybe your stop's positioned somewhere in here. Oh, let me back out and see if you can see the resistance level. See the swing highs? Formed an Asian session and during London lunch right there, suggesting resistance at 153.75, which we break above. And for the hour prior to London close, the pound yen consolidates in a 30 pip range. London close denoted by the vertical red line. Now, if you close the trade at the London close, 5 p.m. London time, you earned at least 80 pips on that long scalp trade. Now, that was about as good as it got for scalpers today. Again, my name is Kurt Worley, and this has been your New York session video briefing from fxbootcamp.com for Wednesday, July 22nd.